the last question, come on.
Sir, it was complete the reaction.
Why boron doesn't form? Why boron doesn't form? Boron plus 3. Doesn't form boron plus 3. Come on, all of you. Who will answer? Santosh, can you answer? Why boron cannot really form boron plus 3?
Sir, because boron plus one ion is stable.
What?
Sir, boron plus ion is stable.
Stable means it has to form easily. Boron plus ion is stable means it has to easily form.
Yes, sir.
Boron sir, atom is very small. Boron atom is very small. The three IP values, first IP, second IP, third IP is very large. Therefore, you cannot easily remove three electrons from boron. Very difficult. Therefore, boron cannot form easily boron plus. It may form, but not that easy. Right. Due to smaller atomic size, greater IP values, boron cannot form boron plus 3. Next. Earth to boric acid behaves like weak acid. Boric acid becomes a weak acid giving H3O plus ender. B was taken 4 dash plus B. H2BO2 plus C. B is taken 4 minus B. H2BO2 minus. H2BO2 minus. In Gala group, 2 minutes time. Sai Srimai, can you answer? Sai Srimai?
I'm not getting it, sir.
Okay, leave it. Amrita, can you answer?
Trying, sir.
Amrita.
Trying, sir.
Right. Boric acid and weak acid forming a HCO plus and Arthi, can you answer?
1 minute. Actually, I didn't copy the question, sir.
What?
I didn't take the question, sir.
Boric acid, weak acid, forming HCO plus ender. Boric acid behaves as weak acid, giving HCO plus ender. Which are on this one? Agalkot?
Yes, sir. 1 minute, sir. I'm trying.
Huh?
Sir, is it option C?
Option C. Option C only. You have taken the ice. H2O equilibrium. three voyage taken, four times now. Three voyage taken rise, voyage. Three voyage taken four minus, and x three plus. Equally much more toward left hand side, therefore, boric acid, axial weak acid, this is an equation, right? Write the reactions of borax. Write the reactions of borax with acids. Reactions of borax with acids. Borax with acids. Borax with acids. On HCl and H2SO4. Two step and one step, both right. Na2, B4O7 plus 2HCl. 2NaCl plus H2B4O7 is H2B4O7 by H2O. H2O, 4S3, PO3. This is a double step equation, single step. Single step equation. Na2 B4O7 to HCl by H2O, single step. Same products. NaCl for S3PO3. Both are same. So they are giving up in two steps and a single step. Two steps we are getting this one, AB, and again B changing into C. Matched sulfuric acid, same. Na2 B4O7, H2SO4. Na2SO4, H2B4O7, H2B4O7, by H2O, same, 4S3PO3, then Na2B4O7, H2SO4, by H2O, same Na2SO4, for ST group, for ST group. Both remember, double step equation and single step equation both. The second time I am trying on the board. The class notes I given again are the form of question. A good concept, at least I am giving you two times. Come to the regular class. Come to the regular class. Where you stop it? Come on. Say where you stop it. What are you doing?
So we completed structure of SIC, sir.
Structure of SIC. Come on. B4C next. B4C, boron carbide. Preparation, boron with coke, carbon, boron with coke, 4B plus C, electric furnace, next time. 3 CN3. Hydrogen and coke. Hydrogen and coke. Hydrogen and coke. So getting 3, 4 C plus 2 HCl. 2 HCl. Something about SiC and D4C water. Okay. Aluminium, SiC, D4C, they are very hard substances, very hard. 5 quadrants of both of these. 5 quadrants of both of these will have abrasive. I hope you know, abrasive means polishing material. Polishing material. Especially D4C. D4C sheets. D4C sheets are having high tensile strength. High tensile strength. Stiffness is very high. Therefore, they won't allow this particular radial to raise to pass through enter. Therefore, the D4C sheets are used in nuclear reactors. D4C sheets are used in nuclear reactors as protective shield to protect from radioactive rays like alpha, beta, and gamma. So even if it is not allowing gamma to penetrate through this. So the D4C sheets are used, the protective shield, the nuclear reactor to protect from harmful radioactive rays. Next, to the high tensile strength, to high tensile strength of D4C. D4C is used in making of bulletproof clothes. Bulletproof clothes are mainly made up of D4C. Right on. SiC, D4C, right? Right. SiC, D4C, both are hard substances. Hard substances. Next, fine powder of these. Use it as abrasive. Next. B4C is having high tensile strength. B4C is having high tensile strength. Tensile. B4C is having high tensile strength. High tensile strength. Tensile strength. Therefore, B4C sheets are used. B4C sheets are used. In nuclear reactors, sheets are used in nuclear reactors. Protect from radioactive rays. Next. B4C is also used in making of Bulletproof clothes, sir.
Sir, can you repeat the last word?
Bulletproof clothes. for interstitial carbides. Interstitial carbides. Right, okay. These are carbides of bronze metals. These are bronze metallic carbides. Bronze metallic carbides. Ba to C. Nb to C. Ba to C. Nb to C. Sc to C3. Ba to C. Nb to C. Sc to C3. Ba to C. Nb to C. Sc to C3. Sc to C3. And Wc. And Fe3C. These are some examples. Under interstitial carbides, these are constant metallic carbides. These are the examples. Remember, these are very hard substances, very hard, and possess high melting points, less reactive, Therefore, the interstitial carbides are used in the making of furnaces in the inner layer. Furnaces in the inner layer, the refractory material. Refractory material. Therefore, interstitial carbides are also known as refractory carbides. But refractory material having high melting point, less reactivity, and not just a thermal conductor. Like that, these particular carbides are having these properties. So, hardness, high melting points, less reactive. Therefore, these are used as inner layer in construction of furnaces. The refractory material, therefore these are not what are refractory carbides. Next time. Look here, Wc, Wc, tungsten carbide, one of the hard substance used in the preparation of white top ballpoint pen. So Wc, one of the hardest carbide used in the preparation of point of ballpoint pen. Point of ballpoint pen mainly made up of this Wc, right up. These are transition metallic carbides. Examples. Ba to C, Nb to C, Sc to C3, Wc, Fe3C. Next, these are hard substances. Versus high melting points. Less reactive. Therefore used in the construction of furnaces. As refractory material. Therefore, known as refractory carbides. Wc, one of the hard substances. Used in the preparation of point of ballpoint pen. Last one. Iron type of carbides. iron type of polarizer. These are type of potential carbide, don't get those, interstitial carbides. Iron type of carbides are a type of interstitial carbides only, type of interstitial carbides. The transition metals, the transition metals which are having atomic radius 1.34 angstroms are equal to or less than, equal to or less than. So the transition metals which are having atomic radius equal to 1.34 angstroms and less than 1.34 angstroms, such a transition metals, they can produce this type of iron type of carbides. Remember, iron type of carbides also one type of interstitial carbides, especially formed by the transition metal which are having atomic radius less than or equal to 1.34. Generally, there is a general formula M3C, where M stands for chromium, manganese, iron, cobalt. Iron, cobalt, chromium, manganese, iron, cobalt, their atomic radius, even nickel also again, nickel. So, chromium, manganese, iron, cobalt, nickel, their atomic radius is around 1.34 angstroms only. The carbides of these four metals, these five metals are coming under iron type of this particular carbides. The iron type of carbides are having intermediate properties again, interstitial carbides, remember, ionic carbides. So, iron type of carbides are having intermediate properties between ionic carbides and interstitial carbides, ionic and interstitial carbides. So, the general formula is M3C, M3C, there is CR3C, MN3C, Fe3C, etc. Fe3C, remember, Fe3C is also already written in interstitial also. This carbide are written in your interstitial, I am saying the same thing, is also one of the interstitial carbide, but the iron carbide especially coming under this particular iron type of carbide. This Fe3C commonly called as cementite. Commonly called as cementite, remember. Commonly called as cementite. This is important component of, remember, stainless steel. Important component of stainless steel. So, the most of the carbides, this is what Fe3C, mainly seen in this what cast iron and pig iron and stainless steel, whatever the carbide is there, the metal carbide in this form, Fe3C. In stainless steel, the important component is what are Fe3C, what you call cementite. What you call cementite. Come on. These are type of interstitial carbides. These are a type of interstitial carbides. Interstitial carbides. Next. The transition metals. The transition metals which are having atomic radius equal to or less than 1.34 angstroms. 1.34 angstroms. Such transition metals form this type of carbides. Chromium, manganese, iron, cobalt, nickel. Chromium, manganese, iron, cobalt, nickel are having atomic radius. Atomic radius around 1.34 angstroms. Angstroms form this iron type of carbides. General formula M3C M3C, heavy cold ore, chrome and manganese iron cobalt nickel. Chrome and manganese iron cobalt nickel. Chrome and manganese iron cobalt nickel. Next. These carbides are having equivalent properties between. These carbides are having intermediate properties between. Interstitial carbides, and ionic carbides. Ionic carbides. Right now, Fe3C cementite. Remember, this is cementite, common called as iron carbide. Cementite. It is an important component of stainless steel. Stainless steel. These are the other components and all. Next, silicone especially. Silicones. What are silicone? Look at the argon silicon compounds carrying SiOSi marks. This type of compound what do you call silicones? Organosilicon compounds carrying SiOSi bonds, what do you call silicones? Types of silicones. One, long chain silicones. Second one, cyclic silicones. Third one, hexa alkyl siloxane. Fourth one, cross linked silicones. These are different types of silicones. We will discuss about the liberation, etc. We will discuss one by one of these silicones. Come on. Argonosilicon compounds carrying SiOSi bonds.
Sir, what is the third one, sir? Hexa?
Argon silicon compounds carrying SiOSi bonds known as silicones. Take the structure first. Silicon structure and first. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now, types of silicons. Now, types of silicons. Types of silicons. First one, long chain silicons. Cyclic silicons. Hexa-alkyl siloxane. Cross-linked silicons. Now, types.
Sir, what is the third one?
Hexa-alkyl siloxane. Hexa-alkyl siloxane. Long chain silicons. Long chain silicones, first one. Right now, starting material. Starting material. Preparation of starting material for the preparation of long chain silicon. Dichloroxylate. Dichloroxylate. Long chain silicon, this is the starting material required. Starting material for the preparation of long chain silicon chain dioxide dichloroxide. Next. Now we have to prepare this one. Preparation of dioxide dichloroxide. Dichloroxide. First one. Not a reagent. You know, bring not a reagent?
Don't know, sir.
Organic not yet started to you? Organic not yet started?
No, sir.
Not yet started?
No, sir.
Not yet started, sir.
Okay. RMDX, known as RMDX. No, R may be methyl or ethyl or propyl or whatever it is. R may be R and methyl, right? MG. What is X? X may be halogen. You can write this one. So RMDX, commonly called as Grignardia, one of the famous compound in organic chemistry. Once organic chemistry started, many times you get this particular, no problem. You want to write down, Grignard reagent, of a cross mineral. Grignard reagent, the side, right side of the green of page. Grignard reagent, RMDX. Grignard reagent, RMDX. You see, CH3-MgCl, cross. RMDX, CH3-MgCl. X may be anything, chlorine or bromine or iodine. Just to add, to have an idea, I'm giving this one. But you know, this is not in organic chemistry, not a common view. Grignard reagent with silicon tetrachloride. 2 CH3 NgCl created was SICM4. Then a reading 3S3 taken twice SICM2 plus MDCM. MDCM. Second one. Proposed direct process. Proposed direct process. Direct process. That is alkyl halide. Organic method. Alkyl halide. With silica, silicon impedance of copper metal as catalyst. Copper metal as catalyst. Eta 540 Kelvin. Right. 2CH3Cl plus Si copper catalyst 540 Kelvin. Then ready CH3 take advice SiCl2. Dialkyl dichloroside. Dialkyl dichloroside. This is the starting material. Take it. This starting material is started for hydrolysis. Don't wait for a while. How am I making a long chain silicon see the board? Don't write. No writing. Listen now. This particular compound we are subjecting for hydrolysis. 2H2O minus 2HCl. This is the actually substituted. See the board. We are reading OH and OH. 3H3 and 3H3. We are reading dialkyl dihydroxysilane. Dialkyl dihydroxysilane you are. This is getting two active OH groups. This is two active OH groups. Easily one of the OH group interlinked with another OH, forming a dimer. First, I will show to you a dimer and you go for the polymerization. See the board. Each monomer, you are having active OH group. Active OH group, see the board. CH3. One more I'm writing. One more I'm writing. CH3. CH3. Whenever they are coming near to each other, easily reacting to each other, minus H2O, minus H2O, then minus H2O, then we need SiO, this is OH and OH. CH3, and CH3. Just a dimer you got. Look here. This is one of the two OH groups, one of the OH groups. These two are interlinked. Still, you are looking on the board. The two OH groups are still active. The two OH groups are still active. They won't keep fight. They easily react with other and form a long chain. Therefore, I am showing you now the long chain silicon formation. See the word, don't write. first try to understand, then we need to write it. There are maybe only two moles. Now I am taking n number of moles, I am taking n number of n. OH and OH, CH3 and CH3. Many are taken. Then you can easily, this is actually linked. Many thousands and lakhs are linked together and forming a long chain. Therefore, SiO, 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 like this. This is what OH, and again OH. This is what CH3, CH3, and CH3. This you are getting long chain. Long chain. So we are writing only few, but many thousands and lakhs are interlinked like this. We are getting what long chain. In the repeating unit, see, repeating unit. Repeating unit is this much only. This is what repeating unit. This is actually getting repeated and getting what a long chain. Take it as it is. Come on. First, second term. First is hydrolysis, second is degradation, third is polymerization. This is long chain. Long chain system.
So what is the second one?
What?
Second one, sir.
Now, yes. What about?
So what is that reaction name?
What is that?
Name, sir. First one is hydrolysis. Now what?
No, simply dimer, sir. The dimer, the polymer. No, for this. Simply addition of two. I have shown that how they are added to it.
Okay.
The dimer won't keep like. You cannot stop here. It will go like this. This is a repeating unit, see. CSP taken by SiO only, not include this one. This is only repeating. This is the repeating unit. CSP taken by SiO.
No, sir.
1 minute, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Hey, completed or not?
Completed, sir.
Difficult or not, sir? Come on, cyclic silicones. Cyclic silicones, everyone. third one. Cyclic circles. See, of the long chain silicon only we are getting cyclic silicon, remember. The long chain silicon, you see or not, long chain silicon at the end, OH groups are there, OH groups, right? Whenever the long chain silicon you are dehydrating, you are removing water, the two OH groups are linking together. The two OH groups are linking together and getting water, cyclic silicon. From the long chain silicon only, by dehydration, you are getting water, cyclic silicon. Therefore, first we have to prepare the long chain. Long chain we have to cyclize. So starting material for the preparation of long chain silicon also, same starting material, dialkyl and dichloroacetate. So first step, second step, up to third step, we have to repeat as it is. At a point first, come on. From long chain silicon on dehydration, from long chain silicon on dehydration, dehydration, cyclic silicon is formed. Cyclic silicon is formed. Cyclic silicon is formed. Silicon is formed. Right. Starting material, same. Come on, starting material. Better write this. Starting material for the preparation of, keep it the same. Starting material for the preparation of cyclic silicon is. Cyclic silicon is. Cyclic silicon is. You know, dialkyl, dialkyl, dichloroacetate. Dialkyl, dichloroacetate. Dialkyl dichloroacetate. Next, preparation of dialkyl dichloroacetate. Preparation of dialkyl dichloroacetate. Dichloroacetate. Repeat the same. First method and second method. Rewrite again, all of you. Rewrite again, same thing. First method, second method, repeat. You have to repeat compulsory. See from you are not there. You have to show to me.
Okay, sir.
Right. Repeat the same. First method, second method, as it is.
Now only, sir.
Ah, now only.
Okay, sir.
Paper summary.
And they sir, place at least Taratarastha.
Yeah, awesome. At Londalan, Paper the Pray Paul.
Yes, sir.
Quality, 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 quality. Postponed to order, right? And Manchin Galu, write down. Paper the Pray Paul, I want to see your notes from there. And the Raj Day. Ethanol reagent with SI, CL4, and ROCO direct process. ROCO direct process, alkyl halide and silicon, copper metal as the catalyst. Completed?
No, sir.
Ah. Completed?
One minute, sir.
Ah. After completing, write the hydrolysis. The analysis, next step, same. completing preparation right to hydrolysis. Okay. Hydrolysis product, dihydroxysilane. Got it? Completed?
Yes.
Right. Now see the word. You got this particular compound, dihydroxysilane minus 2 acyl. This one is very tight. See the word, don't write now. I'm taking 3 moles of this. 3 moles only. 3 OH. OH. See the word. No writing. 3 moles. Now we're writing 3 moles long chain silicon. I'm showing to you first. 3 moles long chain silicon. SI, OH, and OH. This is 3 moles long chain silicon. 3 moles long chain silicon. Right. But I said, the long chain silicon, if you are dehydrating the 2 OH groups, interlink, and we are getting what cyclization I said. This same thing with the word, I am showing in a cyclic form. Same thing right in a cyclic form in the word. SIOH. Same thing, I am not doing anything here. The same thing I am writing in a cyclic form, that's all. Same thing I am writing in a cyclic form. Look at the OH, OH and OH. Each in liquid to 2 methyl groups, 2 methyl groups. Now, what I say? This all dehydration. Then we are dehydrating minus H2O. How we are removing H2O? Come on, see. OH and H. Minus H2O. Then cyclization takes place. Look the word. SI. This is CH3, and CS3. So this is actually cyclation. Now, this is what timer. 3 moles. Together, you are getting the cycle, a cyclic component. Therefore, the name of this is TRIS. TRIS stands for 3. TRIS, dialkyl, siloxane. This is TRIS, 3. Cyclo is cyclic. Dialkyl, 2 alkyl groups are there. TRIS, cyclo, dialkyl, siloxane. This is the name of this particular compound. You can also write 4 moles, you can also write 5 moles. If you want, I can show this particular 4 moles also. Black one will take. As it is, come on, right now. So, hydrolysis you have taken, and 3 moles to take, and how cyclization has taken place. What is the name of this particular compound? Right now. Three moles long chain and cyclic formation and how cyclization is taken place. Then this much are coming here during the next class. Two silicons are completed. Still, two more are there. Yeah.